Simon & Schuster Audio presents Homeschool Hacks, How to Give Your Kid a Great Education Without Losing Your Job or Your Mind by Linsey Knerl. Read by Mia Barron. Introduction, How to Use This Book. If you've picked up this book, or maybe received it as a gift, you're already homeschooling, or at least strongly considering it. Maybe, like so many parents who found their educational support system crumbling during COVID-19, you had previously assumed home education wasn't for you, especially if you were happy with your school. Or maybe it's been percolating for a while, an issue with bullying, lack of personalized special ed resources, or a general feeling that there's something better out there. However, you came here, I'm glad. This book was written to welcome all homeschoolers and those who want to know how to support their homeschooling friends and family. The COVID-19 pandemic has certainly brought new attention to a method of learning that had already been growing in popularity. The observations and advice in this book can be applied by both those who are brand new to homeschooling and those who have been doing it for years. These tips will work for lifers, those who plan on taking it from K through 12, as well as those just trying to get through the semester. And I hope they can also help explain why homeschooling works, so you can share them with grandparents or family members who want to play an active role in helping your children succeed but aren't really sure how. Why me for this book? I've been homeschooling for well over 15 years. In fact, it's the only way my kids have been educated. In 2007, I began writing. It started as a hobby, then became a side gig, and finally blossomed into a full-time career. Just a couple of years later, my husband's career was a casualty of the recession, and we decided to put all our energy into establishing our homestead and growing my business. And it's a good thing we did, too. While it's had its ups and downs, the writing business has not only supported our six kids, but given us the opportunity to watch them grow up close. Has it been easy? Absolutely not. In fact, I never try to sell homeschooling as the easy choice. Like most of the decisions we've made based on our values or our goals for our family, it's been very hard at times. Homeschooling while running a business has sometimes made me feel like I'm not doing either one particularly well. On my worst days, I worry that I'm not spending enough time working with the kids. I also see how some of my peers are making more money than I am because they can spend all day writing books or selling pitches or producing podcasts. It's so hard not to compare ourselves to others. It's a natural human response to any challenging scenario. So what drives us to keep at it even though it's a difficult balance? While I can't always say that my business is better off for our homeschooling, I can say that our homeschool days, and my kids in general, are better off because of our business. Here are just a few of the highlights. My daughter, infant son, and I got to explore New York City as part of a media tour. We experienced the parks, museums, and food while I built industry relationships. This daughter will be graduating college with a degree in media studies soon. My son celebrated his 16th birthday on a plane en route to a conference where I was speaking in Washington, D.C. We saw the National Archives up close before visiting our state senator's office and finished with a tour of the Justice Department. This son is finishing high school with a desire to learn more about law. Our entire family drove to North Dakota for a workshop I taught, stopping along the way for picnics in small parks, views of buffalo, and incredible photo opportunities of the Badlands. Is there anything better for a lesson in geology than seeing these majestic rock structures in person? Over the years, I've spoken at dozens of events. I've covered hundreds of news stories. I've shared thousands of product reviews in my blog posts. And I've had my kids with me every step of the way. I nursed babies in the back of board meetings and taught lesson plans and car rentals and took my older kids to catered dinners while teaching them how to behave around tiny food plates. All these life lessons couldn't have happened if we didn't have the business and if my husband and I weren't determined to use it to help them see more of the world. We've always done our best to show our kids how hard work and an honest business can present new and exciting opportunities. They've also seen how times can be tough when you're self-employed. They know about taxes and working on weekends, and that mom and dad are the ones who pay for the M&Ms in the hotel minibar, so don't touch. They see the fruits of our labor every day, from when I'm working on deadline with an article at 2 a.m., to when my husband lugs home the groceries and lumber for a DIY project at the end of every week. They've watched me cry while recovering from my sixth cesarean section while working up the energy to call a source about an upcoming story, and helped Dad create amazing soups and sauces in our kitchen to keep me nourished. They see the delicate ecosystem that business owners like us maintain every day. It's been amazing. Whether you read the book straight through or start with the chapters that speak directly to your current situation, I encourage you to give every section a try at some point. I've done my best to share universally applicable truths so that single parents can find common ground with married couples and civilians can find inspiration from those serving our country, for example. I'm grateful for the opportunity to interview so many parents about their journeys. While I'll never know what it's like to be assigned to a different state for military duty, I learned a lot about how to handle moving, including what not to put in those boxes, from my military friends. Likewise, families who had nannies to help out or parents in urban areas with access to, oh, so many sports and hobbies, shared unique stories that helped me assess what I'm doing for my own family. Of course, there are also unlimited topics parents can disagree on when it comes to raising kids. From what to feed them to how long they should have a pacifier, it seems like nothing is settled. I understand these convictions. We all want only the best for our kids. If you're reading this book, you may be thinking that homeschooling is one of the ways to do it. And it does have many advantages. Chief among them, the freedom to parent the way you want. You can ensure your child soaks up the good values you want instilled, while also acquiring the necessary skills to face the ever-changing future. You don't have to wait for school boards or curriculum advisors or learning plans to be approved. You can, right now, do what you know is good for your child. Of course, like anything worthwhile, it's not easy. Read through and take notes. It can be a bumpy ride, but one you'll never regret taking. Chapter 1. Who are the homeschoolers? Making the decision to homeschool is like joining a club. So who's already in it? I can't answer specifically for your part of the world, as homeschoolers are as varied and unique as the reasons they've selected home education. Below are some examples. Do you see yourself in these stats? The National Center for Education Statistics, NCES, shared that in 2016, the number of homeschooled students in the U.S. totaled 1.69 million children, or 3.3% of the student population. This was a significant increase from the 850,000 students, 1.7%, who were homeschooling in 1999. Homeschoolers are diverse and becoming more so every year. When the NCES last tracked ethnicity, culture, and race among homeschoolers in 2016, the data revealed white homeschooled students made up 3.8% of the total student population, closely followed by Hispanic 3.5%, Black 1.9%, and Asian 1.4%. More children in rural areas are homeschooled than in cities, with 4.4% of these kids receiving a home education versus 3% of their urban peers. Even fewer suburban families made this choice. Only 2.9% of these children were homeschooled. The big family homeschool myth may not be without merit. The stats show that households with three or more children, 4.7%, were more likely to homeschool than those with just one, 2.7%, or two, 2.3% children. Two-parent homes showed a slightly greater share than single-parent homes. Just 2.3% of single-parent households made this choice, compared to 3.7% of those with two parents in the home. Surprisingly, 2% of the homeschool population had no parents in the home. They were being raised by relatives or friends. However, these numbers don't tell the whole story of the why.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.